talking about molar concept, and under this topic we are going to be dealing with counting or determining number of particles in different amounts of substances. Now I can give examples. Example one, like 24 hours make up a day. A week has 7 days. Number three, a year has 53 weeks. So when you look at these examples, I'm relating two things in one statement. I'm relating hours to a day. That's why you have 24 hours making up a day. I'm relating 7 days to a week. That 7 days are equal to a week. And 53 weeks are equal to a year. Now, instead of saying 7 days, I can simply say a week. Instead of counting 53 weeks, I can simply call them a year. So when somebody writes 53 weeks and I write a year, it is the same thing. So when you are counting a year, you count 53 weeks. When you are counting a week, you count 7 days. When you are counting a day, you count 24 hours. Now, when you bring this context into chemistry term, particles are grouped into sets, and a certain number of particles can be referred to as a mole. A mole. So if I'm to determine or to define the definition of a mole, I simply define a mole as a substance that contains 6.02 × 10^23 particles. A mole is a substance that contains 6.02 × 10^23 particles. So instead of writing 6.02 × 10^23, I can write 1 mole. So at sometimes it is difficult to count this number of particles. So we simplify this number of particles as a mole. So I can say 1 mole of a substance contains 6.02 × 10^23 particles. So this number of particles, or this number here, the 6.02 × 10^23 particles, that number was counted by an Italian scientist called Avogadro. And therefore, this number here is called Avogadro's constant. At the same time, you discover that 12 grams of carbon contain 6.02 × 10^23 particles or atoms. So I can relate this statement to the definition of mole, and I define a mole as a substance that contains the same number as that of carbon. When you talk about particles, now you talk about these particles can either be, number one, they can be ions, they can be, number two, atoms, and all can be molecules. These are some of the particles that you have. So if I have 6.02 × 10^23 ions, that means I have one more. If I have 6.02 times 10 power 23 particles, atoms, that means I have one more of that substance. So when you talk of the molar mass, we simply define the molar mass as the mass of one mole of a substance. So molar mass is the mass of one mole of a substance. Therefore, molar mass is equal to the relative atomic mass. Molar mass is equal to the relative atomic mass expressed in grams. The molar masses of different substances are already established. Examples I can give. You have an element, you have its relative atomic mass, then you have the molar mass. So, example number one, we have hydrogen, its molar mass is 1, the relative atomic mass is 1, then the molar mass is 1 gram. Have calcium, relative atomic mass is 40, molar mass is 40 grams. Have oxygen, Fe is 16, yeah, we have 16 grams there. For example, we have sodium, Fe is 23, and the molar mass is 23 grams. We have magnesium, the mass is 24, this is 24 grams. Have nitrogen, Rm is 14, so it becomes 14 grams. Have nickel, Rm is 59, and becomes 59 grams, and so on and so forth. We discover that the relative atomic mass of substances will always be given. So, say one mole of a substance contains 6.02 and 10^23 particles. At the same time, we can say that the molar mass of the substance contains 1 mole. Now, since 1 mole contains these particles, and this molar mass is also contained in 1 mole, so I can relate the molar mass and the particles. So therefore I can say the molar mass of the substance contains 6.02 and 10^23 particles. So these three statements are the same. One mole of the substance contains 6.0 times 10^23 particles. The molar mass of the substance contains 1 mole. So I can exclude the 1 mole and relate the molar mass to the number of particles. That's why I'm saying the molar mass of the substance contains this number of particles. The second term we can talk about is the formula mass or the molecular mass. Defining the formula mass or the molecular mass, this can be defined as the mass of 1 mole of a compound. This is the mass of 1 mole of a compound. This one is got by adding the individual relative atomic masses present in that compound. For example, if you are required to determine the formula mass of the following compounds, at A, we have water, given hydrogen is 1, oxygen is 16. Part B, we have copper 2 sulfate, and given copper 64, sulfur is 32, oxygen is 16. Number 3, part C, half oxygen molecule given oxygen is equal to 16. Then part B, we have ammonium chloride given nitrogen is equal to 14, hydrogen is equal to 1, and chlorine is equal to 36. You are required to determine the formula mass of these compounds. Part A, we have water, we have hydrogen is 1, atomic mass times the number of atoms. How many are there? There are 2. Then plus oxygen is 16. The RIM of oxygen is 16. Then times the number of atoms, it is 1 atom. Then times 1. This is 3. I mean, this is 2 plus 16, giving us 18 grams. So therefore, that is the formula mass of water. Number 2, for part B, we have copper 2 sulfate. So what we do here, the relative atomic mass of copper is 64 times the number of atoms. How many atoms? It is only 1 atom. Then plus relative atomic mass of sulfur is 32 times how many atoms? It is 1. Then plus oxygen, it is 16 times 4 atoms. So this one will give us 64 plus 32, then plus 64. When you add these ones up, 64 plus 64, we shall get 128. 128 plus 32, then at the end you shall get 160 grams. Therefore, that is the formula mass for copper 2 sulfate. Part C, we have oxygen molecule. Oxygen is 16, then times the number of atoms, there are 2. Therefore, we have 32 grams. That is the relative atomic, the formula mass for oxygen molecule. Then lastly, part D, we shall have ammonium chloride. We have 3 atoms here, nitrogen, hydrogen, and chlorine. Nitrogen is 14, then times 1 atom, plus hydrogen is 1, times 4 atoms, then plus chlorine is 36, times 1 atom. When you add up, we have 14, plus 4, plus 36. This gives us 40, gives us 54 grams. That is the formula mass for ammonium chloride. When you are required to calculate the number of particles given the moles of substances, for example, you are given these 3 examples: 0.25 moles of calcium, 8 moles of sulfur, and the number of hydrogen ions in 2 moles of sulfuric acid. Solution. Part A. Using first principles, we know that 1 mole of calcium contains 6.02 times 10 power 23 particles or atoms. Now, if 1 mole of calcium contains this, what of this given number of moles, the 0.25 moles of calcium contain, you cross multiply 0.25 times this, then divide by 1, is 6.02 times 10 power 23 times 0.25 divided by 1. The answer is the atoms. Therefore, we are going to get, when you cross multiply here, you have 6.02 times 10 power 23, then times 0.25 divided by 1. The answer will be 1.5 times 10 power 23 atoms. In part B, we have 8 moles of sulfur. Again, from first principles, we know that 1 mole of sulfur contains 6.02 times 10 power 23 atoms. So if 1 mole of sulfur contains this, what would the required number of moles, the 8 moles? There are 8 moles of sulfur contain 8, cross multiply 8 times this divided by this one here, 1. 8 times 6.02 and 10 power 23 divided by 1. The whole of this is atoms. So the answer that we have there is 4.8 and 10 power 23 atoms. And lastly, we have number of hydrogen ions in 2 moles of sulfuric acid. Now, when you deal with this one, what we should first know, the true number of ions in 2 moles of sulfuric acid. What we have is sulfuric acid can ionize to give us hydrogen ions, 2 of them, then plus the sulfate ions. But now, this is 1 mole of sulfuric acid that gives us 2 moles of hydrogen ions. What of the 2 moles of sulfuric acid? If I multiply this equation by 2, so I get 2 moles of sulfuric acid will give us 4 moles of hydrogen ions and 2 moles of sulfate ions. So, again, we can use first principles to find the number of atoms that are present, number of ions. This time around, we're asking for ions that are present in 2 moles of sulfuric acid. So, 1 mole of hydrogen ions contains 6.02 times 10 power 23 ions. So therefore, 4 moles, for this time around you have 4 moles of hydrogen ions in 2 moles of sulfuric acid. So 4 moles of hydrogen ions contain, cross multiply 4 times this one divided by 1. We have contained 6.02 times 10 power 23 times 4 divided by 1. The whole of this is in, these are ions. We're asking for the number of hydrogen ions. Therefore, the answer will be 24.08 times 10 power 23 ions. As simple as that. Now, when you look at this, you discover that we get what is required and put it on the right hand side of the statement. Then, what is known is put on the left hand side of the statement. The moles are known, but the number of atoms or ions are not known. So, you put the unknown on the right hand side, whereas you put the known.